it is really tough. It's really tough to switch over to their time zone. It's really tough to switch over to, like, just your meals and everything over to try to get on that regimen again, not throw your body off and just, you know, acclimate that fast. You know, I think it feels great how much we have behind us right now. We feel like that's just a testimony on where we're peaking right now as a team, and we think that we have more in front of us.
Well, our team is definitely very confident going into regionals this weekend, and you know, our team talks about how it's a process, and so we've kicked it up a notch for the past few meets, and we're looking to just continue with that process into regionals this weekend. Well, I think for us, our team is looking at the fact that, yes, it is a long trip, but at the same time, it's going to be a fun trip, and it's going to be a good practice for nationals as well. We got the itinerary earlier this week about, you know, what our trip is going to consist of, and we even have some shopping thrown in there, so it'll definitely be fun. And you know, we always enjoy just being around each other for a few days on the road, and then looking forward to that meet as well. There'll be several other teams out there, and I know we have some family and friends from home and from, you know, our different places around the country who will be there as well. So it's going to
have about 10 people there, and I don't think half the people have seen me perform in a competition for probably about a year or so, I mean, besides my family. But I am so excited just for them to finally get the atmosphere of being at a college collegiate gymnastics meet, and it's so different than a club meet or actually the Olympics, so it's kind of cool. And a lot of my teammates that are coming to watch me are actually enrolling in school next year, so it's going to be a nice treat for them knowing that there's someone that they're close to in this meet and get a good experience. I mean, obviously nothing compares to our home meet and having a sold out crowd every time, and it's the energy was a little bit different because it was more of a, you know, condensed energy, and we really wanted to do well, and we did do well, and it was just more of a focused meet, I think, and it's good practice for nationals and regionals. Your confidence, I think. We're going to use this totally to our advantage and know that we can still improve, because that was just our average, and we can totally build from that and hopefully get, you know, more high scores, and nothing's stopping us.
I think it's great that our most recent performances have been our best, but not only that, I think it's really important that we look back and we realize that we're doing things right and that we are peaking at the right time, because on any team in any sport, you want to see, you know, your best performances towards the end of the season when it counts the most, and I think that we're proving that we're doing that, and so we're coming into regionals with a great attitude and knowing that we're ready. I mean, this year we've had so many, you know, high scores and record-breaking things, and so it's really been a year of just so many great achievements, and because of that, I think it's very hard to compare this with any other year. And if anything, you know, I think that we're both best set up for success this year than we ever have been since I've been here. You know, it's hard to say exactly why maybe things didn't work out before, but I know that this year is working out because we've done the work and we've set out a plan and we've stuck to it, and finally it's paying off. I mean, I feel like it was a great thing for our team to do so well on beam, and we set the pace at the meet on beam, and it was great. And so for both of us to come out of there with a beam title, I couldn't think of anybody better to share a title with, and I think it just speaks volumes of the strength of our team, especially on beam.